Okay, yesterday a company called Cerebras released a family of models, which is really interesting, that they're calling Cerebras-GPT. So if you don't know who Cerebras are, that's not totally surprising. They're a company that has been around for a while. They basically make hardware for training deep learning models. And if you look at their hardware, it's pretty amazing. They're making these really big wafer chips compared to sort of like a normal GPU. These things are huge. And the idea is that they're trying to make it easier and quicker for people to train very large models. And obviously, one of the challenges that they've had is that in the deep learning world, people tend to either stick to NVIDIA and NVIDIA GPUs or go the route of perhaps TPUs. And while there have been a number of companies in trying to break this that perhaps NVIDIA's had on the deep learning space, people are still mostly using NVIDIA GPUs. So it's great to see that this team is doing a bunch of stuff. And what they released to show off their ability to train models is this family of models called Cerebras-GPT. So this is, like I said, this is not just one model. This is a group of models. And they're interesting to look at. One of the things I would say up front is that when they launched this yesterday on Twitter, they also put a link to a Discord. And I went in there and saw people asking questions about these. And there's some interesting comments from the people at Cerebras. And one of the comments that I found most interesting was that the comment that I've quoted this, these models are optimal for a fixed compute budget, not necessarily best for use. So I think that's key to remember here is that they're trying to show, okay, what could you do for a fixed compute budget to train a model? And that doesn't mean these models are going to be the best for use. So they've got these variety of sizes. So we're starting at 111 million parameters, going up right up 13 billion parameters. They've got a 6.7 billion parameter model and a 13 billion parameter model, which are kind of similar the sizes of the low-end llama models that we've looked at multiple times. So it's interesting to see how do these models compare to what's out there. The other interesting thing is they've adopted what's known as the chinchilla scaling formula. And that basically determines the number of tokens that they're going to use for each model. And the way they've interpreted it is they're going for 20 times whatever the number of parameters are. So even when you look at these bigger models that sort of around the 7 billion parameter one, they're only training it with 140 billion tokens. So this is not ideal. Like the chinchilla scaling thing makes a lot of sense when you're talking about the chinchilla model, which was 70 billion parameters and therefore trained on 1.4 trillion tokens. If we compare this to the llama models, the llama 7 and the llama 13, these were both trained on 1 trillion tokens. So it's a lot more tokens than the Cerebras GPT family have been trained on. Anyway, they're interesting to look at. One of the great things is that these are totally open source. They're basically got an Apache 2 license. You can fine tune them. You can do what you want with them. You can put them out there, that kind of thing. They're definitely worth having a look at. And if you wanted to, I guess you could then use Cerebras' products to train them. So not only do they have processors now, but they've also got a whole cloud suite where you can go in here and train models yourself. So that's something that's interesting to look at. So the good thing for us is that they've uploaded all the checkpoints on to the Hugging Face hub. So if we come in and we look here, we can see that there are all the different sizes here from the 111 million right up to the 13 billion parameter model. And you can see they've only literally been up sort of 10 hours at this stage. I'm going to look at the 6.7 one because I think this is a nice size where we can compare it to some of the other models that we've been talking about. But I encourage you to go and have a look at the whatever size you can run and have a play with it. So the 6.7 billion one, I've set up a collab and I've set up a collab that actually can load any of these. Depending on how big your GPU is, you can go from the 111 small ones right up to the big one. Like I said, I'm looking at the 6.7 billion one here. I'm bringing these in just in the normal way. So I'm not actually using the bits and bytes 8-bit, but you certainly could if your GPU perhaps not going to load one of the bigger models, you could then try loading in it as an 8-bit model. Maybe I will put in another example later on of the loading with the bits and bytes so that people could try that. And then we could just try these out. So the cool thing is these are set up to be totally compatible with Hugging Face, in that we can basically bring in a pipeline for text generation. We can then put in the info that we want. We can generate text. So basically, these are completion models. So they're just going to predict the next word. They're causal language models. And here we've got it where it's basically doing generative AI is, and then you can see the output is a process of creating a model of the world that can be used to create, and it's going along. You're going to find that the quality of these is so-so. Sometimes you get really good results, sometimes you don't. This is really just trying this out. So you've got two options for doing the generation. You can do it as a pipeline, and this is an example of doing it as a pipeline, or you can just do it as a traditional model.generate. And here I'm just passing in a generation config, setting the temperature, setting the top P, setting a repetition penalty, passing that in, and then generating out. So unicorns can be found in the forests of the world. The unicorn is a mythical creature with a horn, right? So unicorns were very famous from GPT-2 days. It's interesting to sort of look at it and see, okay, how does this compare even to one of the early GPT-2 models when you're playing with this? So you will find, though, if we try to put in, say, the alpaca prompts, it doesn't do very good straight out of the box. So this is below is an instruction. This is a typical alpaca thing where we're asking, what's the difference between sheep and alpacas? And you can see that it really doesn't handle this very well at all. If we ask it in a just a straight up way, the difference between alpacas and sheep are, and it will basically give us better completion than this. And this is because these are not instruction fine tuned. What I've done is I've gone and taken one of these models, the 6.71, and I've basically done an instruction fine tuning with the cleaned alpaca data set here. If you want to use this checkpoint here, you're most welcome to use it and try it out, because this is trained on the clean alpaca data set. This is not for commercial use. Remember, the cleaned alpaca data set, or the alpaca data set in general, is not for commercial use. But you can have a play with this in here. So this is basically just bringing this up, and you can see that if we ask what is an alpaca in here, we're now getting a lot more useful responses out of the model because we've trained it with the instruction fine tuning. It still seems to have a problem with knowing when to stop. So it tends to just go on and on. Maybe that could be helped by more training. I'll look at that in perhaps in the future. We can see here, like I ask it, okay, write an email about why GPT-4 should be open source. And it will generate something. GPT-4 is one of the most popular machine translation systems in use today. It has been used by many companies to translate their documents. So it's obviously hallucinating a lot, which is what we'd expect, that we're not trying to get accurate facts out of this model because it's not trained on a lot of tokens. So if we compare this model, it's trained on roughly around 140 billion tokens, as opposed to the llama model, but the base llama model, which is trained on a trillion tokens. But I still think it's worth having a play with it, seeing what you can do with it. It's probably a really good model to practice doing any fine tuning or something like that with one of the small models, because these models are so interchangeable. You could just get all your code working on this, do some test runs on 111, and then go for one of the big ones, the 6.7 or the 13 billion parameter ones for this. So anyway, I thought I'd just make a quick video to show you what this was. Perhaps you've seen people talking about it. And if you want to have a play with it, as always, I'll put the collabs in the description below the video. If you've got any questions, please feel free to put them in the comments. And as always, if you found it useful, please click like and subscribe. I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.